So the easiest way to create a YouTube gaming banner for your channel is using a free tool like Adobe Express. Now, they do have a paid option, but today I'm going to show you how to utilize the tool so you can make an amazing banner. And thank you, Adobe Express, for sponsoring this video. So everything that I'm going to mention is going to be in the description of this video. All the resources to make the banner, all the tools that I'm going to recommend are going to be in the description below. So when you come to Adobe Express, you're going to see here it says get the free plan. There's no credit card required, so you simply go ahead and sign up. You just want to have access to some of the premium features. If you decide to start using this because you start making gaming thumbnails, then you may want to consider going to another plan, which can be $99 a month or $99 per year. But once you get signed up, you're going to be brought to a dashboard just like this. The first thing that you want to do is you want to come up top to where it says search content. You want to type in YouTube banner, and that's going to give you a YouTube banner. That's going to give you the right size that we need for the banner. So if you look here on my channel, this is the size of the banner. We want to make sure that everything that we want seen can be seen on mobile and on desktop. And the goal of your banner is to clearly explain to the viewers that are coming to your channel what it is that you do and why should they care about your channel. This is how you get people to start subscribing, start watching more of your content. So you want to do this right. So it's not just about how you design it, it's what you put on the banner as well. Okay, so in order for us to begin this process, if we just design on a white screen just like this, we're not going to know exactly where to put text, where to put images. And today we're going to make a Fortnite banner, but all of the skills and the tools that I'm using can be utilized for any game that you're going to play. You just want to follow the principles that I'm showing you here today. So the first thing that you want to be able to do is, and this template is going to be in the description below, but I'm going to come here and I'm going to get the YouTube banner template. Okay. And this is this template here. So once you download it, okay, all you're going to do is you're going to come here to where it says upload. You'll upload the picture and then you're going to have it here. And then you just want to size it up and make it as big as possible. So what you're going to see here is that you're going to see that we have a TV size, a desktop size, a tablet size, a desktop minimum and mobile. So what we want to do is that we're going to design everything to fit within this text and logo safe area. That way we know 100% it's going to showcase good on mobile and on desktop without any issues. So once we have this here, that's going to be step number one. Now we need to go ahead and grab some images for us to be able to utilize. So again, because I'm doing Fortnite, I'm going to simply come either to Fortnite's website or whatever game your website, they typically have some really good images that you can go ahead and save and use for your banner. Because again, if I'm playing Fortnite, I want my viewer to instantly know exactly what my channel is about. So if I have a Fortnite channel, I want to maybe showcase some Fortnite characters or even maps of Fortnite. I just want to keep it simple, clean, and make it easy for my viewer to say, okay, this is a Fortnite channel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come to Fortnite and I'm going to save some of these images here. If your game doesn't have a website that has images, you can simply come to Google, type in your game, go to images, and then you're going to see tons of images for you to be able to select from. So you'll simply come through here and you'll right click and just hit save, and then you should be able to be good. Then once we have our images, we're going to come back here to Adobe Express and we're going to begin this process. So you're going to come here, you're going to upload. I encourage you to upload all of the images that you went ahead and saved so that way you don't have to do it over and over again. Once you have all your images, which I have my images here, we can begin this process. So here's what you want to be able to do. So let's say that I like this image here. Okay. So what I can do now that I have my image, I have two options here. I can use the image as is, meaning that I can come ahead and just size this down, place it in that, place it in to fit inside this box, right? So I can do it just like this. And then what I can do is that I can make the background kind of a similar color so that it gives me more space. So what we can do here is you can come to click on background, hit this little kind of icon here, which is like a dropper. You want to hover over the background or the color for that image, hit it. And then you're going to see here that now we have this color background, right? So the reason why we're not seeing it right now is because we have this template, but you can see here that now we have that yellow and it kind of blends in really good, right? So what I can do is I can go ahead and move this image on this side, let's say for example, and then say I wanted to go ahead and put my text on the left-hand side. So that is option number one, okay? Right now, all we're focusing on is getting our image and our background set up. Then we'll focus about text a little bit later. Now, if you didn't want to use the background from the image, here's one of the cool features that you're able to utilize in Adobe Express, which is removing the background. So if I click on this image, you're going to see on the left-hand side that it says edit and remove background. So if I click this, it's going to use AI to try to remove the background. You can see here now, it cleaned it out perfectly, and now I have the characters without any background, giving me way more flexibility on where I place them. So now I have that there. I have these characters. You can start to see how this is starting to come together. And if I remove this here, you're going to see that they're going to be on a yellow background. So again, just making it super easy for me to be able to go ahead and adjust and utilize this. So now that we have our character there, right? Everyone that comes to my channel is going to know that this is a Fortnite characters that are in Fortnite. But we need some text so that your viewer knows exactly what your channel is about and why they should care. So what we're going to do is we're going to come to the left-hand side and we're going to select text. We're going to go ahead and hit add text. And this is going to allow us to add in our text here, right? So all I want to do is you don't want to be so long-winded with the text. You want to be very clear, short, simple, and easy. So if my Fortnite channel is about improvement, like let's say I teach Fortnite players how to get better, how to build faster, then what I want to do is I just want to quickly make it easy for them. So what I'm going to say here is I'm going to probably put learn, right? I'll probably put a little slash play, and then I'm going to put dominate. Okay, so I'm going to do it just like this. So here's what I want you to kind of see what I have here. So I'm going to double click on this. And for right now, I'm just going to change this to the color white, okay? Just so I can be able to see it and adjust it where I need it to be. So what you want to do is you want this to be as big as it possibly can. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hover over and bring these characters over just a little bit more because I want the text to be the main focus. So I'm just going to come and make this a little bit bigger, and I'm just going to place it there almost right at the hand. Right. So now I have that in place, but we need an additional text. Learn, play, dominate is not enough for my viewer to understand why they should care about this channel. So I'm going to click on this text. OK, and we're going to make a few edits on it before we duplicate it to make more text. So if you want your text to be able to pop out, which we do, you're going to come here. You're going to click on it. You're going to come to where it says effects. OK, and when you click on effects, what you're going to do is you're going to look for something that says here classic. And what this does is adds a little bit of shadow behind in black so that it pops out. Okay. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to leave that just like that. Now that I have that in place, I'm going to click on this again and you're going to see here, there's three little dots. You're going to click duplicate. And now that text is going to have the same exact font. It's going to have the same exact edits and effects. And that's exactly what we want. So what you're going to type in here, I'm going to look for why should my viewer care about what it is that I'm doing here. So I'm going to type in win smarter, right? Because I know they want to win more. And I know that they want to build faster because the faster you build, the easier it is for you to be able to stay alive and stuff like that. So I'm going to have that there. So what I want to do here is I want to start to organize this in a way where my text is going to fit right. So you're going to see here that I have it aligned and Adobe Express does a good job of giving you these metrics so you can know that things are lined up. Okay. So now that I know that I have this in place, here's what I want to do. I just want to go ahead and peek for a moment to be able to see where things are. So this is where we're at right now. Okay. Now, I think that I want this text to be a lot bolder because, again, the goal is to make it be seen. So you want to come to where it says edit here, and then you what you want to do is you want to click on this little bold and be able to do that, right? So now you can see that that looks so much cleaner, and now I can kind of center this and leave that smarter there. But we want a little bit of contrast, right? Because what's happening here is that the yellow and the white, it's like too much. So what we probably want to do is we want to make this text most likely be black, or you can use a color that contrasts. So let me show you what that means here. So if you come to Google and you type in color wheel, okay, what you're going to see here is you're going to see these series of colors. And one of the things you want to do whenever you're trying to think about contrast is that you can come here and take a look at, well, we have a yellow background. Okay, so what are some colors that contrast? And typically that's colors that are across or kind of next to each other, right? So I would always go across first. So I have like kind of like a yellow, kind of like sitting in here. So I can go with this purple or I can go with this blue, right? So that lets me know that if I use those colors together, it's going to go ahead and look good. Here's another one, right? So yellow and purple look really good together. So that could work. So let's come back here to Adobe Express and let's try to see what a color of purple looks like on this. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab this little pencil icon and I can come to the Adobe logo because it does have a little bit of purple on here for me to be able to utilize. And then I can go ahead and do that. Now, for me, it doesn't contrast and pop out enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to also try a blue here to be able to see. And this is the process that you kind of want to go through. And you want to be able to just try to see what's going to work, what's going to pop out more for this to be able to show. And again, remember, we can change the background if we wanted to use a different color background as well, right? So you don't have to always just use a yellow. You can pick any color or even your brand colors to be able to utilize. Then let me see what this looks like in black, right? So let's see here. So the shadow behind is making it a little bit harder to see the actual black. So we can come to effects and we can maybe try like a smooth, and that makes it a little bit better. Same thing for the top. Maybe a smooth would make it look a little bit better. Okay, so now that we have that in place, I'm going to bring this back up because what we want to do now is we want to try to make this as big as we possibly can. Again, remember, the goal here is to make sure that this is seen as best as possible, right? So I'm just going to make this a little bit bigger, and I'm just going to make this a little bit bigger, and I'm just going to make these characters a little bit smaller because it's okay that they're not top to bottom because I want to be able to make sure that the text is the thing that's seen the most. Okay, so now that I'm happy with the way that this looks, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to delete the template. This is now going to give me my banner that I can go ahead and utilize. And you're saying like, hey, but what about all this extra space that's around here? Remember, that's totally fine because what we want to focus on is desktop and mobile, which is mainly where people are going to watch your content. So once we have this set the way that we want, we want to come to the top and we want to hit download. You're going to hit PNG. You'll hit download. This is going to go ahead and save to your folder. I have my folder saved here. And now what I want to do is that I want to come to my YouTube channel. So when you come to your YouTube channel, you're going to go ahead and click on this icon for your profile. And that's going to bring you to your YouTube studio. Once you're here, you're going to come to the right left hand side and select customize. You're going to see where it says banner image. Now, we're going to sit here and hit change or add if you don't have one. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to come to my downloads and I'm going to click on that banner. Now, you're going to see here that because we went ahead and did it using the template, you're going to see that we have this here aligned, right? So what you can see here is that everything is in this little space here that I need. Now, the dominate is a little bit almost on the cusp of getting it there, but it should be fine for me. And if I wanted to, I can come back here and adjust it just a little bit to give myself a little bit more space to make sure that it's not 100% touching on the line, right? So I can come here, hit download, download it again, come back here, and then I can make that adjustment. So let's here, click change. There's my new updated one. And you can see here that now we're in alignment. So this is how you go ahead and start to create a banner that's going to showcase to your champ, hey, I know this is Fortnite characters. Oh, what am I going to learn here? I'm going to learn, play, and dominate. You're going to win smarter. You're going to build faster, right? Because I'm going to teach you how to improve. That's the learn. I'm going to teach you how to play. That's the fun part of my gameplay. And then I'm going to show you results and master because I'm going to get you better at the actual game. And then all I need to do is go ahead and hit done. And that's going to go ahead and save my banner. But here's the thing that I want you to kind of think about. just having a banner on your YouTube channel alone is not going to be the thing that's going to get you to get viewers to find you and also get them to subscribe. What it does is gets people to understand what your channel is about. If you want people to be able to go ahead and find you and watch your content, you need to understand how to make good gaming thumbnails. So in this video here, I show you step-by-step using Adobe Express how to make gaming thumbnails that gets your viewers to click and watch so you get more views and subscribers. Click that video right there, and I'll see you in the next one.